Patellofemoral injuries fall into a large group. We have a variety of injuries to the patellofemoral joint, including just routine run-of-the-mill overuse patellofemoral pain. Somebody who doesn't remember having an injury. They just know that they woke up and their knee was hurting, or they went for a run and someplace in the middle of the run their knee started hurting. And that's an overuse syndrome that we term patellofemoral overload syndrome or patellofemoral compression syndrome. It's the most common thing that brings people to orthopedic surgeon's office for knee pain. Is anterior knee pain is another term we use for it, but it is pain underneath the patella, and it is pain with certain specific things that load the patella. So those patients will complain of pain when they run. They'll complain of pain if they're going downstairs preferentially, but stairs in general are painful. Down is usually a little worse than up. Squatting, lunging, anything that puts weight on a loaded bent knee will aggravate the patella. Women will often tell me that heels bother them if they wear heels, because again, it puts their foot in a position and then puts the patella, pressure increases behind the patella when you put your heel up. A patellofemoral injury is an injury to the knee joint that predominantly affects the patellofemoral articulation, which is the connection between the femur, which has the track or the groove that the patella, which is the kneecap, runs in or tracks along with every time you bend and straighten your knee. Patellofemoral instability is a condition that where the patella or the kneecap does not stay in the groove or track that it's supposed to. It comes out and then it has to get back in. So this is the trochlea, which is the groove in the femur for the patella, and this is the patella. I'm going to lift up the tendon. As you can see, as you flex and bend and flex and straighten the knee, extend the knee, the patella lives and glides up and down in that groove.